Hey, Bel Air Youth, I just wanted to share some announcements as well as invite you into a spiritual practice this week. So this week is Holy Week, which Holy Week is the week leading up to Easter. And so there are a lot of significant days that take place during Holy Week. The first was Palm Sunday. Then we have Maundy Thursday on Thursday night, which is the night that Jesus shared a meal with his disciples before he was betrayed. Then we have Good Friday, which was the night that Jesus was crucified. There's Holy Saturday, which is the day in which the church laments that God has died in Christ. And then it culminates in Easter, which is the celebration that Jesus has raised from the dead and has defeated the power of sin and evil and even death in our world. And so we have at Bel Air Church of the Nazarene a few opportunities for you all to connect. Tomorrow night, Wednesday, we're going to be having a Holy Week Zoom conversation. This is going to be very similar to the conversations we had on Facebook Live a few weeks ago and then the one that Heather hosted last week on Zoom. So that'll be at 7 o'clock. I'll be leading it. Lauren Miller will be there to help lead it. And Heather and Lara will also be there. So I want to invite you all to join us at 7 o'clock tomorrow on Zoom. I've sent the Zoom link in our Facebook Community Life page. Then we have our Tenebrae service on Friday. That's going to be at 7 o'clock on Facebook, just like our Sunday services have been. And then on Sunday morning, we're going to have an Easter service, again at 9:30 on Facebook. And so these are the three things that we are doing this week for Holy Week. All of our small groups, I believe, are still going, so I encourage you to engage there. We, as a youth group, are going to have our next youth group Zoom this Thursday at 7 o'clock. It's going to be very similar, or sorry, not 7 o'clock, at 6:30. And it's going to be very similar to last week's, where we're going to have a game and then we're going to talk about, does the Bible contradict itself this week? And we'll split up in high school and middle school during this time. And then I want to give you one last announcement. This is going to be a new game that we are going to play as a youth group. It's going to be called BAY Cribs. So I don't know if you all have seen MTV Cribs, but back in the day on MTV, there was this show called Cribs where people would show off their house and how great and how wonderful it was. It was often athletes or musicians or movie stars. But we're going to do something similar here. And so BAY Cribs, BAY stands for Bel Air Youth, or Bay Cribs, is going to be this time where I'm going to start it off next week and I'm going to show you my house. You all have been here before, and show you some of the things that I've been doing during quarantine and then offer a word of encouragement. And then I'm going to challenge a few people to do the same thing. And then if you decide to make a video, you'll show us your house, you'll show us some of the things you've been doing, and then you can offer up a word of encouragement, a funny joke, a prayer, whatever you would like, and then you can challenge other people to do the same thing. And so if you do this, you will get points for our auction for whenever we're able to gather again. So you don't have to do this if you are called out or challenged, but I encourage you to do so because it's going to be fun and you'll get points to use in our auction. Well, now I'm going to talk about the practice that I'm practicing this week, and I want to invite you all to also practice. And that is the prayer of Examen. And the purpose of the prayer of Examen is to notice God and our God-given desires in our daily life. And so Adele, not the singer, but Adele Calhoun, said this about the purpose of it. It is a practice for discerning the voice and activity of God within the flow of our day And it is the vehicle that creates a deeper awareness of God-given desires in life. And so the practice of aware or examine has been one that Christians have practiced throughout Christian history. And it is a practice that we talked about a lot in our series on anxiety, because in our series, we talked about how we need to acknowledge these anxious feelings in us. That anxiety, whenever we get it, is telling us something. And so the prayer of examine helps us examine ourselves, helps us examine our situation, and also helps us to find God and listen to God in our situations in life. And so some of your teens, and if you're watching this teens, you should be somewhat familiar to this practice. And so the prayer of examine is a time when we come into the presence of God and invite God to examine our day, our situation, and even our own self. Often, for me, when I practice the prayer of examine, I do it at the end of the day, right before I go to bed. But it is also a helpful tool for you, and for me, and for anyone who wants to practice this, to do at any time there's a difficult or stressful situation that you want to get down deep and to understand what is going on. So when I practice the prayer of examine, I often spend a moment to center myself. We talked about centering in our last spiritual practice, and centering is where you focus on a word, a phrase, or even an image to help you center on God's presence with you. And then I'll start to think about my day, and I'll ask God to bring to mind the threads of my day and my activities. And as each moment of my day comes to mind, I'll ask some of these questions. So I'll ask the question, where did I give or receive love in this activity or interaction? How did I withhold love in this activity or interaction? Which activity or activities filled me with love? And which activity or activities drained me in this day? And so, and then after I do this, I reflect on where God was at in those moments. Another way you can do this is, as you're thinking about your day, write out a list of feeling words. You can just write as many or as few as you want. So these words could be things like acceptance, anxious, confused, disgusted, ecstatic, undecided. And then you can ask yourself the above questions that I just mentioned. So like, which activities filled me with love? And I'll write this in the video description so that you have it written down for you. And so then you'll think about these words, and you'll think about your day, and you'll see which ones match up with your day. And then lastly, you can make a game out of this. And so next time that you sit with your family at a mealtime or another time where you gathered, you can teach everyone the game of examine. So the game is very, very easy, and it's like I spy. And so you basically just say, I spy God. And then you reflect on a moment in your day where you saw God at work in your day, or when you encounter God in your day. And then you can invite the rest of your family to explain the ways that they spied God in their day. And this helps you examine your day and examine where God was present with you during the day. And so I just want to encourage you all to practice the daily examine, because I think it will especially help us as we might be experiencing these moments of anxiety, of uncertainty, of fear and nervousness because of all that is going on around us during this time of COVID-19. And so I want to invite you into this, and I hope that you have a great Holy Week. I know that it's going to be different not gathering together on Easter Sunday or even for our Tenebrae service, but I just encourage you to take moments to reflect on the uniqueness of this Holy Week. And maybe God is drawing you into a new understanding of what Holy Week might mean for you. And so I'm here and I'm praying for all of you. If you need anything, please reach out. I hope you have a great day, and I pray blessings.